Now to question number 6 of NECP 2019-20. In this problem, we have three particles, particle 1, particle 2, and particle 3. This is velocity time graph for particle 1. This is velocity versus time graph for particle 2. And this is velocity time graph for particle number 3. And we are supposed to find relationship between the magnitude of average acceleration for all three particles over 10 seconds. Okay, now you see the magnitude of average acceleration. In general, the average acceleration is given by the expression, this is equals to change in velocity per unit time. And the magnitude of average acceleration, that should be given by the magnitude of change in velocity per unit time. Now, because the motion is one dimensional, and hence we need not to follow the vector sign, we'll take plus for the forward direction and minus sign for the motion in the reverse direction. If you look at particle 1, initial velocity is 0, final velocity is minus 2. So particle 1, v initial is equals to 0 meter per second, v final is equals to minus 2 meter per second, delta v is equals to v final minus v initial, and this is equals to minus 2 minus 0, and this is equals to minus 2 meter per second. So delta v modulus, that should be given by 2 meter per second. And the average acceleration for particle 1, that is equals to delta v by delta t. This is equals to 2 meter per second divided by 10, and equals to how much? This is equals to 0.2 meter per second square. Now just look at for particle number 2. For particle number 2, initial velocity is 2 and the final velocity is 0. Initial velocity is plus 2 meter per second, final velocity is 0 meter per second. So delta v in this case is equals to v final minus v initial, and this is equals to how much? 0 minus 2, and this is minus 2 meter per second. So the magnitude of change in velocity, that should be given by 2 meter per second. Now average acceleration for particle 2, this is equals to delta v by delta t, and this is equals to how much? 2 meter per second divided by 2 second. This is equals to how much? This is 10 in fact. So this is again 0.2 meter per second square. And let's see for particle number 3 as well. For particle number 3, initial velocity is 0 and the final velocity is 2. So the change in velocity is still 2 meter per second during the same interval of time. So we expect that delta v modulus for particle 3 is equals to how much? 2 meter per second. Delta t is again 10 seconds. So the average acceleration for particle number 3, this is equals to delta v by delta t modulus, and this is equals to how much? This is 2 by 10, and this is equals to 0.2 meter per second square. So what we expect, that the average acceleration of particle 1 is same as average acceleration of particle 2, is same as average acceleration of particle 3. So we expect that answer D is correct. Thank you.